This is Rifika.
Yeah, that'll work.
Are you born and raised in Houston, bros?
Yeah, born and raised in Houston, Texas. You know what I'm saying?
Born and raised in Houston, Texas, and now yeah. You live in Vegas. How long you been in Vegas?
This is my third year, but I ain't going to be here much longer.
Why you say that?
I'm about to move to Atlanta in June 28th with my lease up. I'm moving to Atlanta.
Word?
Uh-huh.
Why you leaving us?
It's time to go, and I feel like it's more opportunity in Atlanta. My girlfriend in Atlanta, too. You know what I'm saying? It's more opportunity for acting, and it's the capital for Christian hip-hop also. So I think it's a win-win. This is going to be actually my last year teaching elementary. I'm going to go full-time in my music and my acting going forward.
Word.
Yeah.
Okay. So you must have saved up a grip of money, man. You finna go full-time. You finna walk in that faith, ain't you?
I'm walking on faith. I'm stepping out on faith, bro. You got to, because when you hear all them stories about people doing that, they always just went forward with it full-time. They didn't keep their regular job, because a lot of times they keep you from certain opportunities. You know
yeah,
what
they
saying?
Went for broke.
I'm going to give me like a flexible gig, several flexible gigs if I have to, until I get something, you know, get something big or whatever.
Okay. Don't forget the little guys.
Nah, I never will. No.
You don't have children, right?
No, I don't have kids.
Yeah, you better go for broke, man. You better sleep in that car, man.
Yeah, you better do what I said. If I gotta sleep in the car, I'm gonna sleep in the car. I'm gonna do what I gotta do.
Yeah, you gonna make it, man. I believe in you, brother. Like for real, man. For real. Music, musicianary?
Yeah, that's right. Musicianary mixtape. Yeah.
Okay, musicianary mixtape.
Yeah.
What does that mean to you? What is musicianary?
I was at this conference called Objective in Nashville several years ago. I think it was like 2016 or 15. And I met these old school Christian rockers, like old school Christian rock bands. And they call themselves musicianaries. And I was like, that's real cool, because what they do is they go out and they do music everywhere. You know what I'm saying? All over the world. They're spreading the gospel through music, just like a missionary would, but they're not doing music. So that really resonated with me. And that's why I named the mixtape Musicianary Mixtape, because since my last project, Fresh Manor, which was my last album, I've done shows, you know, overseas. Like I did a show in the Virgin Islands. I did a show in the Bahamas. I did a show on a Carnival cruise ship. I also have my music played on various stations around the world now, done interviews on them, you know what I'm saying, and stuff like that. So that's why I feel like I'm a musicianary.
Yeah, that's what it is, man. Music and missionary work, you feel me, on that field. You know what I mean? Yeah. Uh-huh. That's pretty much what I am myself, you feel me? So I salute to you on that, brother, 100. When did you become a Christian hip-hop artist?
I started, man, 2002, my senior year in high school. That's when I started out and started rapping for the Lord. So in June, it'll be my 18th year doing Christian hip hop. It's been a long road, you know what I'm saying? But I know this is what God called me to do, because every time I try to stop, he always sends somebody across my path to let me know that there's still a need for my music. And he always provide the resources that I need to make my projects also.
Yeah, 100. So what producers, or not producers, what engineers did you work with to put together this project?
I worked with Preach, actually. Brian Preach Bennett. That's who I worked with on the project. And actually, man, I'm very happy to have connected with him, because everything that I asked for, he was able to do. And I asked for some extras, some hard stuff on this mixtape to get, like, you know, different people on there. Like one song I got Marvin Gaye on there singing. One song I got Aretha Franklin on there singing. One song I redid the B.O.B. track by Outkast, and that was kind of challenging as well, but we made it work. So he can work miracles on that board.
Ah, 100, man. Shout out to the boy Preach, man.
Yeah.
1,000. So what makes you say, I'm not going to preach the word, I'm a rap the word, or do you preach?
Nah, I mean, I feel like what we doing is rapping through, preaching through our music. You know what I'm saying? That's the approach that I always took. Recently, I had opportunity to actually deliver the word at a church, I believe it was Generations Church or something like that in January, actually. They wanted me to rap and deliver the word. So I'm starting to come out of my shell with that if asked, because I know if a pastor asked me to do it, then God definitely laid upon their heart for me to do it. But, you know what I'm saying, I prefer the comfort zone is just to rap a lot of times.
Righteous, righteous. Now, do you ever have plans to maybe start a church, plan a church, help build a church, or is it going to continue to be musicianary work?
Nah, that's for me. I mean, whatever God allow, whatever God want me to do, but at this point, I feel like he wants me to continue to do the things that I'm doing in the entertainment industry. Like I talk about on the album, I have a lot of different talents, but I know that he wants me to take those talents into the mainstream, like with my acting or whatever. You can't just do Christian movies and stuff like that, you know what I'm saying? Even though I'm going to let my light shine in whatever I do, you know, with my music, it's the same way. I went through a program called Actors Models Talent for Christ, and they actually teach us how to utilize the entertainment industry as a mission field. And I went through that program in 2017.
That's dope. That was in Vegas? Or you went somewhere for that?
They actually were located. It's actually not around anymore, but we still have the community being folded right after I went through in 2017. But they were located all over there. Base was in Atlanta, actually, but they had different hubs. Like they had a Dallas hub, which I was a part of before I moved out here. Then when I moved out here, I finished up in L.A. I would drive out to L.A. to finish up, and we did the Shine Conference out there. So they had them in, like, Seattle and New York and Florida. They had them all over the nation.
Okay, so what do you feel about cursing? Because I hear your lyrics, and, you know, you like Christians don't curse, you know what I mean? So when we talk about being an actor, you know, how do you feel about that? You know what I mean? Are you not gonna take that that job? Are you looking? You know what I mean? You get what I'm saying?
Yeah. Well, for me, it's like there are certain words that I want, a lot of different words that I won't say. Now, the words that are in the Bible, if that presented itself in a role, I would say them. But those harsher words, I wouldn't, that's not in the Bible, I wouldn't say, because they vex my spirit. A lot of different roles I would not take. That's why I prefer to do film more so than TV, unless I'm doing like a kid's show or a commercial or something like that, where I can actually see what it is. Because a lot of times when people do TV, especially these adult shows, they don't know what direction the writers are going to take their character in. But with a movie, you can see the script from start to finish before you decide to take this part or not.
So you more so gonna pick and choose your roles?
Yeah, and when you have an agent, you let them know up front what you're willing to do and what you're not, you know, what you're not willing to do. And actually, I have a few agents that's looking at me when I move out to Atlanta and stuff like that, so I'm gonna let them know. If they try to submit me for something that I don't want to do and I already told them up front, that means I need to find another agent.
Right. That means they're going to try to make you compromise.
Yeah, I'm not doing that. If I'm not comfortable, I'm not doing it.
Okay, so let's get back on the mixtape, man. When the mixtape drop, man?
Yeah, the mixtape drops officially March 21st. Like I said, I shared it with everybody that had a hand in it today. You know what I'm saying? But if they look closely, you know what I'm saying, they may be able to stumble upon it early, but if not, they're just going to have to wait till March 21st when I start posting it. But if y'all do some digging, you can hear it early.
Right, right. How many tracks on that thing, man?
It's 14 tracks on it.
Okay. And what made you say a mixtape instead of a project, instead of an album or an EP?
Ever since Lecrae started doing the church clothes mixtapes back in the day, I saw his format of mixtape, album, mixtape, album, mixtape, album. Yeah. So that's what I'm following right now as well. Okay. Because when you do a mixtape, it allows you to broaden your fan, create new fans, you know what I'm saying, from you giving them something free. It's like you're giving them a sample. You know, yeah. And when you put out your album, then they'll be more apt to listen to you and check you out.
Okay. Do you have any videos that may be coming out of this?
Yeah, I redid Summertime. I don't know if you remember. I sent it to everybody this summer, and it was actually pretty big, and everybody was enjoying it. This summer, I did a lyric video for it, but maybe since I'm moving, I may not end up doing it this summer. But you never know. I may, but definitely by summer 2021, I'm gonna put out a music video for Summertime. Well, I want to get footage out here. I want to get footage in Houston. I want to get footage in Atlanta, possibly. You know what I'm saying? Kind of show that story, because I talk about, you know, our childhoods growing up in the summer and all the kind of stuff. Talk about us in college or when we in our 19s and 20s and stuff. And then talk about us when we're adults, you know, what Summertime means to us.
Now, when you look at H-Town, right, where you was born and raised, right?
Yeah.
Did you fall into the lean world? Did you sip lean and listen to DJ Screw and ride around in your Trues and Bogues on foes? You feel me?
No, I didn't sip lean and all that kind of stuff. You know what I'm saying? I wasn't in that. By the time I got to the point where I could drink anything like that, I wasn't sipping lean or nothing like that. I did used to listen to all that music and stuff, and it did heavily influence me. Now, I did have a lack. I had a CTS that had rims and all the chrome and all that on it. You know what I'm saying? I was swinging that for a little. You know, I had to before it got wrecked or whatever. So, yeah, that was about the extent of that. But I did listen to a little bit of Screw. So, on the mixtape, I don't know if you heard it yet, but I do have a Chopped and Screwed record on the mixtape also for people to enjoy. Take it back to the H-Town flavor. And the DJ I use, DJ Overflow, from H-Town as well.
What made you want to hit us up and get shout-outs on that thing, man?
It was actually his idea. Whenever I do a mixtape, I like to do it like the right way, the old school way, where you have a DJ host it. Now, I don't really feel like it's a real mixtape if a DJ not hosting it, scratching, mixing it, them transition straight and all that. And I like to get that DJ creative control. So what I asked him to do, you know what I'm saying, just whatever your ideas are. And he asked me, you know what I'm saying, do you know any artists or anything that you can get shout outs for the mixtape? And I started sending out the texts, and it was an overwhelming response, you know what I'm saying? But we got all of them on there.
It was an overflow, man.
Yeah, it was an overflow. Which was a blessing. Okay. I was happy.
What does RIFICA stand for? I know it's an acronym.
Yeah. RIFICA is an acronym which stands for Righteous in Faith, Increase Abundantly.
Righteous in Faith, Increase Abundantly. And was that in a dream? Was that something you just came up with? What does that stem from?
When I had first started rapping, a guy by the name of Mike B, he already had like a local label called New Camp Entertainment. He the one gave me my opportunity when I was 18 years old. And I was writing secular raps, but I wasn't ever laying nothing down in the studio. I was putting my own stuff together, like with a karaoke machine and stuff. And when I was doing that secular stuff, playing it for my friends, I was calling myself Master Ball or whatever. And I tried to take that same name into the Christian rap arena. And one day he called me. He was like, Justin, I've been telling people your name and they not feeling your name. Then he hung up the phone. He's like, change your name or whatever. So right away, I think I took like two steps. And then the Holy Spirit put in my spirit, RIFICA. And not too long after that, he gave me the meaning for it, Righteous in Faith, Increase Abundantly. It wasn't like, you know, like a haiku poem where I had to sit up there and think of the name or with each letter mean and all that. For the acronym, it just automatically came to me. So I know that's the name the Lord wanted me to have.
Like instantly, I feel it. Yeah. I feel it. It just rolled off your tongue. I feel that. I feel that. Mm-hmm. And did you go to college?
Yeah, I went to college. I went to Prairie View A&M University.
And you became, you. What did you get your degree in?
Music education. So
you're a music teacher.
Yeah, I'm a music teacher. I've been teaching music for, this is my 12th year, my 12th and final year. I did my time. You know what I'm saying? But it's been a great journey though. I've got to work with a lot of kids on everything from playing instruments. I taught band for 3 years at Willow Ridge High School in Houston, Texas. I've taught elementary music for 9 years. So I got to work with kids on their dancing, they singing, they rapping, they comedy. That's what I enjoyed the most, was working with the kids on their talents.
Right, right. Tell them, man, because some people, you know, don't feel like they need to get an education as an artist or in hip hop. You know, we so gung ho on just doing our own thing and being independent. You know what I mean? Why did you go to college?
It was just something it was something I wanted to do, you know what I'm saying, from like a kid or whatever, really growing up watching A Different World, you know what I'm saying?
Hey, talk about it, man. They don't know about No Different World, man.
I know about A Different World, so it made me want to go to college, and then my brother went to college, my oldest brother, he went to Prairie View A&M too, so I come from a Prairie View family, you know,
okay.
On my mom's side. I'm the first one in that immediate family on my mom's side to go to college. So I just wanted to experience that. Plus, I'm in band. I was in band. So I went to a predominantly white high school, you know, and we had to do the white style of band. I mean, that was cool and stuff. But I always wanted to experience the historically black college style of show band. So that
right.
Made the influence in me going to college also so I could experience that, and I really did enjoy doing that as well, playing the jams on the radio and dancing and all this stuff.
So you was on a real drum line.
Well, I'm a tuba player, but I wasn't. They had right. A drum line like that. They you
right.
Know what I'm saying? They based their drum line off of my college's drum line. Seriously, they did
wow.
Because they were like known back then as the number one drum line in the country and stuff. And they do all those tricks and different things like that when they marching in our marching band shows, which you saw in Drumline. That's what they did, a lot of acrobatics and stuff. The box did all that.
I want to ask you a few more questions before we end, man.
Okay.
Your stage performance, why is that important to you? You know, when I seen you, I don't know what you do now, but you'll put on something nice, like you going to dinner, you know what I'm saying? Like a suit top, a blazer, you know what I'm saying? You got what do you call that on your arm? What do you call that?
The wristband.
The wristband. And you give us a show. So why is that important to you? The dress, the style, and what you do on stage. Why are those things important to you?
It's important to have an image, man. Whatever we do, we must do in excellence for the Lord. You know what I'm saying? So I would have gave my all, you know, if I was in the world. You know what I'm saying? So while I'm not going to give God my all within bounds, of course, you know what I'm saying? Not going too far like they do in the world. But that's my way of praising the Lord. You know what I'm saying? If I'm dancing or the way I dress over there, it just depends. And the reason why I was wearing like the blazers and all that kind of stuff at that point was because when I did the Fresh Manna album, that was more so a throwback type album with some of the type of songs and beats that I chose to use. So that really matched what I was, you know, what I was wearing or whatever. But that's just what I pray about. A lot of times I pray about what to wear before I wear. The Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit to give me an outfit. You know what I'm saying? And that's the outfit that I wear on stage that day. So if I'm wearing a suit, that's what he wanted me to wear. If I'm wearing a button down, you know what I'm saying, with the armband and the leather pants, whatever, that's what he wanted
right.
me to wear that day. You know,
right,
I
right.
mean, it's very important because we trying to reach people. You know what I'm saying? We trying to reach
yeah.
people. We can't reach people sitting up here, standing in one spot on the stage, you know what I'm saying, ballet rapping. People don't see that. You move a lot. You do a great stage performance yourself. You know what I'm saying? So I know you can relate to that. You know, people
yeah.
want to see something. They want to see a show. Even though it's
right.
not about putting on the show, but this is entertainment ministry. You know what
right,
I'm saying?
Right.
And when people
right.
see that, that's going to cause them to check out your music and learn about your life, learn about what you're about and get ministered to.
That's absolutely. Learn what Christ did for me. You feel me?
Yeah.
So you said you started doing Christian hip hop your senior year in high school.
Yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
When did you come to Christ? When did Christ come to your heart? And when did you confess and believe?
Man, I grew up in the church, but you know, when we grow up in the church, we don't always live it. You know what I'm saying? I actually remember going up confessing Christ when not from 3, and then I would always do it a lot after that. But I feel like when I totally gave my life to Christ was after I graduated from college. You know what I'm saying? Because even though I was doing Christian rapping stuff, I wasn't living totally holy. I wasn't totally living what I was rapping. But after I graduated from college, really even before I graduated from college, I started feeling a pull on my heart. I wasn't comfortable with messing with all these different women on campus and stuff no more. You know what I'm saying? I became celibate before I actually graduated from college. You know what I'm saying? Because
yeah.
I wasn't comfortable. I was convicted. You know, so
yeah.
that senior year, all the way up until I got married, the first time that I got married and stuff, I was celibate like 2 years, you know what I'm saying? And I remember being in I went home, you know what I'm saying, like most people do when they graduate from college, and I started watching those Left Behind films. I had seen them before when I was younger, but this time when I was watching them, it was something different. Like, they was really tugging on my heart, and I could feel the Holy Spirit really working on me. I remember getting prostrate before the Lord and bawling, and it was really emotional. And that's when I knew that I had truly gave my life to God. And I started doing my standard album, which is where the gospel stuff came out of. And once I totally gave my life to Christ, that's when I really started seeing things start to happen to line up with this music ministry, and the prophecies that he had given me throughout the years started coming to fruition.
Righteous, righteous. So, you're looking at Atlanta, right? Mm-hmm. I hope all is going to be well. March 21st, Musicianary. It's going to be on, where are we going to find it at? Your website? Where are we going? Where are we getting it at?
YouTube, Bandcamp, Reverb Nation, and That Pip. That's where it's going to be. All those. And it'll be on my, the link will be on my website. Also, the YouTube will be on the homepage and all this stuff where people can check it out.
And where do everybody follow you at?
On all social media sites, I'm at Riffica777 or at Riffica. So go ahead, hit me up, subscribe, all that good stuff. Hit the notification bell, follow, and I will follow you back if you're positive. I love to connect with you.
That's Riffica.
Yep.
777. Okay. Riffica777. How many projects you got out?
This will be my sixth, believe it or not. I got 3 albums out and 3 mixtapes now with the Musicianary.
Word. Word. And we can find them all at the same place on your Bandcamp and YouTube, your YouTube.
My website, Riffica.net, actually has all of them on there.
The
very first one, Motivation. And then on Bandcamp, you can find all the way back to The Standard, which is my 2010 release, all the way up to the Musicianary mixtape. Now, I don't necessarily put the old one on there because, I mean, back then it's totally different Riffica. You know, I was rapping by Christ, but, you know, you go from glory to glory to glory through the years. You know what I'm saying? I want to give God our best, so I don't put that one on there. But people can find it on my website if they want to go back in the archives.
Right. You just grow and you feel like you may have been better than you were then. So it's like, we ain't gonna go that far back. I feel it though.
Yeah.
I feel it. Man, so blessings on your journey, bro. June, man, are you doing a going away party in Vegas or what? Concert, something? What you doing?
Nah, man, there's been talks of people throwing a going away dinner for me. You know what I'm saying? But I mean, if somebody wanna put something together, I do it, but I mean, it is what it is. I ain't gonna make a big deal out of it unless somebody wants to.
Okay, for sure, for sure. That's about it, man. So I want everybody to follow you. I want everybody to listen to the Musicianary. Hey, if you can, man, go ahead and go see if you can find it right now. You feel me?
Yeah.
but officially March 21st, man, and Musicianary will be out. By Riffica. Go to Riffica.net and check the boy out. Subscribe to his YouTube. It's Riffica777 on YouTube too?
Yeah, Riffica777 on YouTube. Yep.
For sure. And that's about it, man. I appreciate your story, man. The celibacy part of it, man, and you know, your senior year and prior to you getting married and really giving your life to the Lord, man, and actually rapping about Christ since you were young, man. And just you going for broke after this, you know, this spring, man, going into the summer, going to Atlanta, man, really chasing your dreams and really, you know, knowing and believing in your heart that this is what God is calling you to do. You know what I'm saying? New music coming. So that's dope. That's why we're doing this interview. I wanted to get you in there. And, of course, I want to get you on the radio show as soon as possible. But I know you work. The coronavirus here, so you might need to go on and come to the station, man. We got that 12 o'clock for you if you want it.
Yeah, I'm free the next 3 weeks. The next 2 weeks I'll be here because they didn't shut it down till April 16th. I'll be in Atlanta after that, like the 5th through the 13th. But before that, or them 2 days after, I could come through, definitely.
So I'm supposed to have somebody come this week, but he has not responded since he asked me to be on the show. And we may just go ahead and fill you in there, brother. If not,
what
I got next Thursday. I'm on Thursday, 12 noon, or Fridays at 12 noon.
Okay.
Yeah. So today is Sunday, so you know we got a couple of days to make it happen. But I'm gonna figure it out for sure and let you know ASAP to come in on Thursday. If I don't get a response from the guy within the next 24 to 36 hours, feel me?
All right, yeah, for sure, that'll work. And mm-hmm. I got a couple, well, definitely one original track that could be played on the station and all that, because I know how y'all do it. Y'all keep it right on there, so.
For sure. And, man, want to give a big shout-out to Preach, man. Make sure you share this with him, bro, because he is a dope engineer, man, one of the ones who do it for God and God's people. So, you know, he got you sounding good. Big shout-out to DJ Overflow for making that thing happen. You feel me? And everybody who gave a shout-out on the music missionary, the missionary, musicianary mixtape.
Yeah.
And, yeah, that's about it, man. I appreciate you for your time today, bro.
All right, man, I appreciate you for inviting me on, man, anytime.
So 100, man. All right. Bless, bro. You be safe.
Yes,